Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to update from Windows 10 to Windows 11 on a computer with unsupported hardware. So if your computer supports Windows 11, normally you would be able to update using the Windows 11 Update Assistant or ISO file. But if I try and do that on this computer, I get an error message saying that this CPU isn't supported for Windows 11. That happens whether I use the Update Assistant or I try and update with the ISO file. So in this video, I'm going to show you how to upgrade your unsupported PC to Windows 11, and it doesn't matter which error message you're getting when you're trying to update to Windows 11. By using this method, you'll be able to update to Windows 11 on any unsupported system. To start, open up your web browser and then go to this web page. Now I'll have this web page linked in my written guide, which will be the first link in this video's description, so you can go ahead and get it from there. But on this page, we can download Rufus, which will help us create a bootable USB flash drive and remove the Windows 11 requirements. On this page, just scroll all the way down until you find the download links. And for most of us, the first option, which is the standard 64-bit, will be all that we need. If you have other hardware or software on your system, go ahead and download any of the other versions. But I'm going to be downloading the standard version. And once Rufus is finished, I'll just click on Open File. Accept any user account control prompts, accept the check for updates prompt, and then the Rufus window will open. Now we can start creating the Windows 11 installation media for unsupported hardware. To use Rufus, we'll need a device where we can write the Windows 11 installation files to, and if you have a spare USB flash drive that's at least 8 gigs in size, you can use it for this purpose and you can go ahead and plug it in now. But for those of you who don't have a USB flash drive, just follow these steps to create a virtual USB drive on your computer. Start by doing a search for disk management. The best match should be the create and format hard disk partitions from the control panel, so just click on that. Once you're in disk management, click on action and then on create VHD. This will create a virtual hard disk on the computer. First, we'll need to change a location, so click on browse. And then I recommend that you navigate to your C drive, and then here you can create a new folder, and I'll just call this VHD. I'll open this folder, and then I'll give this virtual hard disk a name, and I'll call mine virtual USB drive, and then click on save. For the virtual hard disk size, I'll change this from MB to GB, and then I'll make it 16 gigs in size. For the virtual hard disk format, I'll leave this on VHD, and for the virtual hard disk type, you can also leave this on fixed size. Then just click on OK. This will now create a virtual disk on your computer, and that's what we'll be using to create the Windows 11 installation media that we can use to upgrade our unsupported PC to Windows 11. So once it's finished, you should see another disk appear, which will not be initialized. So you need to right-click on this disk and then click on Initialize Disk. Make sure that it's selected and leave it on GPT, and then click on OK. Once that's done, you can right-click on this unallocated space and then choose the option that says New Simple Volume, and then this wizard will launch. Just click on Next, leave that on default, click on Next. You can choose a different drive letter here if you want. I'll just leave it on D and click on Next. You can leave all of these options on default and then just click on Next and then on Finish. And now we've successfully created a virtual USB drive. So just go ahead and close the disk management. And if you go back to Rufus, if you did all of these steps correctly, you'll now see your virtual hard disk listed here. So just make sure that it is selected. Next, we need to select the Windows 11 ISO file. I've already downloaded the latest Windows 11 ISO file, and I have a separate guide on how you can get this Windows 11 ISO file from Microsoft, which I'll link in the description of this video and in the cards now. When downloading the Windows 11 ISO file, just make sure that you choose the same region and language of the Windows 10 version that's installed on the computer that you're trying to upgrade to Windows 11, or else you won't be able to keep your personal files and apps in the upgrade process. So once you have the Windows 11 ISO file, come over to Rufus, make sure that disk or ISO image is selected, and then click on this Select button. And now you need to navigate to where you saved the Windows 11 ISO file. I saved mine on the desktop, so I'll go ahead and find it on my desktop and then double click on it to open it in Rufus. And then you can leave all of the other options on default And if you want, you can change the volume label. I'll just change this to Windows 11. This is what the USB drive or a virtual USB drive will be called. And once I'm done with that, I'll just click on Start. And this is where we can customize the Windows 11 installation. And the main option that we all want checked here is this first one, which removes the hardware requirements for 4 gigs of RAM, secure boot, and TPM. And this will also remove the error I got saying that my CPU is not supported. Now you also have some other options here which you can choose, and they'll help you save time when setting up Windows 11 for the first time. Now in this guide, we're going to be upgrading to Windows 11 from Windows 10, so the rest of these options don't matter at all. These are only relevant if you do a clean install of Windows 11. Now although these settings are irrelevant for this guide, I'm just going to go ahead and choose them all. And once I'm done with that, I'll just click on OK. And then we'll just get a warning saying that all of the data on this USB flash drive, or in our case, the virtual USB drive, will be destroyed. So if you're using a USB flash drive and you have files or data saved on it, just make sure that you have backups of those before continuing, as they will all be destroyed. Once you're ready, just click on OK. And then Rufus will start creating the Windows 11 installation media that we'll need to upgrade our unsupported PC to Windows 11. And this process normally takes around 10 minutes to complete. Now once Rufus is complete, you can just go ahead and click on close. Then you want to open up your file explorer and go to this PC. And then you want to find your Windows 11 USB flash drive that you just created with Rufus. Go ahead and open that, and then you'll see the Windows 11 setup files. And then to start the upgrade process from Windows 10 to Windows 11, go ahead and double click on this setup application. Accept any user account control prompts. And once the Windows 11 setup wizard has launched, just click on the setting that says change how setup downloads updates, and then change this to not right now, and make sure that this box is unchecked, and then click on next. It'll do some checks on our PC to make sure that we can install Windows 11, and next you'll see the license terms. Just go ahead and click on accept. It'll do some more checks on your computer, like checking if you have enough space. And once that's done, you'll see the screen that says you're ready to install, and you'll see the option that says install Windows 11 and keep personal files and apps. Again, if you can't keep your personal files and apps, it means you chose the wrong language when downloading the Windows 11 ISO file. So just go ahead and download it again, and this time choose the correct language. Now just to show you that this is still the same computer, if I open up the PC Health Check app and I do the check, the CPU still isn't supported for Windows 11, but by using the USB flash drive or a virtual USB flash drive we created with Rufus, we can install Windows 11 on this computer. So to go ahead, just click on install, and then you'll see the first installing Windows 11 screen, and your computer will restart a few times during this process, and you can expect to wait around 30 minutes to 2 hours, depending on if you have a solid state drive or hard drive in your computer. When the Windows 11 upgrade is finished, you'll see some setup screens. This first one prompts you for your privacy settings, and I recommend that you just turn off all of these sliders and then click on accept, and then you'll be taken to your Windows 11 desktop. And once you're on the desktop, I recommend that you go to settings and then Windows update, and then just download and install all of the latest available Windows 11 updates. If your update seems to be bugged, just pause the updates for 1 week, and once you've paused it, just go ahead and click on resume updates, and it'll then start checking for updates on Windows 11. I do hope this guide helped you out. Please like the video and go ahead and watch any of my other helpful guides on this channel, and I'll see you in the next one.